Once again, welcome to ITSE 2309. This is chapter 2, data modeling. I'd like to go back and talk about an architect scenario. If you were an architect and a client came in and you're sitting there discussing items with your client, and in your office you would have a small model. Well, a model is a representation of things to come, a facsimile of things to be. Anyway, as you're sitting there discussing a potential new home for this customer client, as the customer client is talking, you in your mind as the architect are conceptualizing what the final product should be. And you're sitting there talking to them, and as the discussion goes on, you know, you're visualizing a house that's 70 feet by 70 feet, okay? And as you're talking to the customer, you know, you're talking about a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 2-car garage type scenario. So in your mind, you're saying, oh man, this is gonna be slam dunk. You're sitting there counting the dollar bills that you're gonna make. And as you're talking with a client, the client says, oh, by the way, the lot is 50 by 50. You say to yourself, okay, a constraint, but the house is still buildable. So now what you're looking at is maybe a 2-story house. So you'll have 2 stories. Eh, it's still okay. So you say, well, in your mind, you go, I can still do it. Eh, more problems, but it's still doable. And you're sitting there talking to the client, and you're sitting there going, okay, this is going to be okay. And then all of a sudden the guy says, by the way, you know, one of the reasons we chose this lot was because it has a beautiful view. The lot has a 30-degree slope. And you're going, holy moly, now can I still? Well, yeah, now what you're doing is maybe you'll have a pier beam or the garage will be on the bottom, but it's still buildable. There's an evolutionary process that has occurred in the model that you're considering to build. Now, as this goes on, if I was to show you a set of plans that had a bathtub in it, could you see the bathtub? More than likely, yes, because you know what a bathtub looks like, right? Well, there's also something else you have to consider, because if you see the bathtub, that's just a graphical representation of something. There's an implied infrastructure that is needed for the bathtub. You have to have hot water, cold water, and drainage. So the symbol itself, the bathtub, says that you're going to take a bath. But there's also some infrastructure that will develop. So we have some graphical representation that is used to exhibit how the house will be built. As such, also with a database. So as you're building a database, there are graphical representations that are used to indicate how this process will be built. And the three models are called the CHAN, the UML, and the CROW. Now, once again, as you develop this process, the symbols that are used to indicate how data and how tables are connected, if there's a symbol, just like with a bathtub, where in order to have the bathtub, there's an underlying infrastructure that supports it, when you see a UML structure, or you see a CHAN structure, or you see a CROW structure as a representation of how things are going to happen, there is an implied infrastructure that's supporting that methodology. So one of the things you have to consider is that the symbolism is a representation of what you're going to build, but also the symbolism carries with it the idea of an underlying structure that is required to support the methodology that you're doing. And that concludes chapter 2.